I'm in Norway. This is the first time I've ever tried to thrive, let alone survive, in a truly cold climate. And I've just had a very close shave.
I'm only just above the high tide. I'm quite pleased I decided to build my camp where I did. I was very close to be building it on the dry grass, which is now underwater.
So far, I've found water and built half a shelter. But I'm worried the fire I've made isn't going to keep me warm. It's not burning nearly as efficiently as I'm used to.
The wood's dry enough, but the problem is the ground around here is absolutely sodden, and I think the moisture is just being soaked up by the fire and just killing any inherent heat.
I need to find a way to make this work.
See, this is right underneath where the fire was, and it's wet. It's not just damp. That's ridiculous. I need to get rid of all of this moss, I think.
You know when you have a little niggle at the back of your mind, but you ignore it, and it causes you to be slightly unsettled? The fire had been one of those.
I can use that for my shelter.
By spending half an hour stripping away all the really sodden moss back to bare rock, I can see the fire is happier. That was time well spent.
With just 3 hours to sundown, I need to finish my shelter.
This couldn't be more urgent. I really need to get a roof above my head. I suspect late this evening, if not tonight, we're going to get a heavy downpour.
The plan is to give it a really steep roof. It needs to be 60 degrees from the floor. This will shed rain and snow and reflect heat back onto me when I'm lying on my bed. For the roof, I'm using the moss I pulled up from beneath the fire. It's heavy, but should keep me dry.
Okay. I've got to do something about this fire. At the moment, partly because of the rain, partly because of the cold, partly because all the wood is damp, the starfire method, I've got to acknowledge, it just doesn't work. So I'm going to try and make myself a full body length fire. Having said that, I've never done it before.
Okay, I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Massive logs now. All I need to do is lie two of them down on the floor, remake the fire, and fingers crossed, we should have a more efficient system. Now I feel properly warm.
I came in here thinking, I know fires. A star fire suits every occasion, and yet every bit of advice had told me before you need to make a longitudinal fire, and I thought, you know what, that's not really necessary. It will just burn too much wood too quickly. And it doesn't. When it's really cold and damp, this type of fire works. And it's really cool to be humbled enough to learn something new.
But the night brings an unwelcome surprise.
Might have put a little bit too many logs on the fire. Normally I'd be really worried about that if my shelter had caught on fire, because it would go woof. But in this instance, that sodden moss, and it's been raining all night long, it's never gonna go woof. Drama over, drama over.
I've been in this freezing landscape for over a week. I have fire, shelter, water, and enough food to survive. Now, I can afford to up my game and venture further afield. I want to thrive.
Ho, ho, ho. There is a massive fjord. Look at that. Right, how can I get down to it?
My fjord dries out twice a day, so there isn't much seafood. But this is a proper coastline and should be teeming with shellfish.
I've never seen so many mussels. Look at these.
These are not bad. Better than tiny little snails.
We can have a feast. An absolute feast. Okay, little addition to my final supper of mussels is a side salad. This stuff is very edible and really, really good for you.
Sea lettuce, seaweed, and mussels.
At long last, it's time to eat.
I think a bit like potatoes, seaweed needs to go on first because that needs a bit of a roasting, I think. Nice birch bark plates to put it all on. Have myself a little meal by this fire.
And open up the most fantastic looking mussels.
It just looks like proper food. The amount of fat and protein in one of these mussels. Oh, it is actually wonderful. That is amazing. They say that hunger is the best sauce. Crikey, that is one of the best mussels I've ever had. And my side salad is a Japanese speciality. Sea lettuce. Not bad. Ow! Flaming seaweed. Sounds like something Batman would say. It's been a pretty good and successful journey as far as food is concerned. To have such a quantity of mussels and sea lettuce, I could eat this till the cows come home. It means that we could sustainably be here through all seasons. Lovely final supper. I think part of thriving, part of not just surviving is relaxing. It's being able to feel so secure in your state of play that you can do things that aren't actually essential. You think it's time, on this nice dry day, to add a mattress topper to my spruce mattress. This stuff here is so squidgy, you can just put your face in it. It feels like a big sponge or, I don't know, something that you'd wash yourself in the bath with. It's still a bit damp to the touch, but I reckon by the fire, it's gonna dry out and make a really, really comfy bed. I have a mattress topper, toasty warm fire, soft fluffy mattress.